tradition of excellence, a tradition unmatched in the Yankee Conference, a tradition based on a simple ingredient, winning. Led by Bill Boes, the winningest coach in Yankee Conference history. In his quarter century at the helm of the Wildcat program, his teams have won 63% of their games. 65 players have earned first-team All-Conference honors. 18 have gone on to sign NFL contracts. Few schools around the country can match the success enjoyed by the University of New Hampshire football team. New Hampshire, located in Durham, a small New England town of 12,000 people, is in the center of everything. Just an hour's drive from Boston, the Atlantic Ocean is just a few miles to the east. Some of the nation's finest ski areas are just to the north, in the famous White Mountains. UNH was founded in 1866 and has long been recognized as a leader in education and in research. Over the years, the university has experienced incredible growth and now enrolls 12,000 students from 47 states and 54 countries. As the student body has grown, so has the campus. In recent years, over $60 million worth of expansions and renovations have taken place, which will provide students with state-of-the-art teaching and research facilities. And the university now has one of the finest on-campus arenas in the country. The brand new Whittemore Center houses sporting events, concerts, and more. Connected to the arena is a new recreational facility with top-of-the-line fitness equipment. Home of UNH Sports is WMUR-TV. New Hampshire's largest TV station provides complete coverage of Wildcat sports, including live coverage of all the football games at home. WMUR's signal reaches 1.9 million homes in New Hampshire, Massachusetts, Maine, and Vermont. Wildcat football isn't only enjoyed by those in New Hampshire. There are UNH football followers throughout New England. The challenge was a big one when the 1995 Wildcat team opened training camp. The three members of the 1994 offensive backfield were busy in NFL training camps, but on defense, everyone in the league knew who the Wildcats had back in the fold. They needed to look no further than the front line and Mike Foley. What more can be said about Foley? All-American, a two-year All-Conference and All-East selection, and in 1995, the Bulger Low Award winner, given to the top defensive player in all of New England by the Boston Football Writers. And you may want to keep your eye on him come draft day. Some experts think he'll be the first player from New England picked in the NFL draft. On the other end of the line, another standout, Joe Walker, strong and quick. Not much got by number 98. Along with Foley, they anchored the best defense in the Yankee Conference and one of the top five in the country. Foley and Walker led an experienced group on defense. In the middle of the front line, senior Ray Lyons, relentless Ray Lyons. The defensive tackle was a big thorn in opponents' sides all year. Side of the ball, it's a good chance number 54 was on it. Seven sacks, four fumble recoveries, four blocks. Yankee Conference teams will be glad to see him go. Along with Lions, UNH fans will miss three other standouts on defense. Oliver Asmar did a little bit of everything in 1995. He stepped up to play linebacker, stepped back to play in the secondary, and came up with two interceptions on the year. Wes Mills made his presence felt. He wasn't breaking up a pass, he was picking off a pass, going all the way for a touchdown in a win at UMass. And the leader in the secondary, Rob McCoy. He went out in a blaze of glory in 95, 5 pass breakups, 2 interceptions, 77 total tackles. Number 2 was number 1 in many ways for the UNH defense. The offense isn't losing as many players, but two guys who made immeasurable contributions to the UNH program are leaving. Chris Borden was a 3-year starter on the offensive line, a standout on the field, but also in the classroom. The holes on the right side were big thanks to Borden and to the man to his left, Sean Finneran. The coaching staff asked him to switch from defense to offense to start the year. He did that, no questions asked. Well, the only question asked was by opposing defenders wondering who or what hit them. More than likely, it was Sean Finneran. Another guy who did a little bit of everything, one of the captains, Matt Mesquita. He showed his trademark versatility in 1995, scoring on the ground at UConn and through the air against James Madison.
On the 37, biggest play of the game for the Cats. Bresnahan wants to pass.
Mesquita
wide open.
Wide open, Matt Mesquita. He's got to catch it. He does. Mesquita takes it in for the touchdown.
From place kick holder to punt returner, Matt was there for the Wildcats. On special teams, number 8, Jason Roby could be seen sprinting downfield and making a hit, but he's one of the departing seniors who will be missed. And it looks like the Wildcats will stay on top in the years to come. With 16 starters returning, UNH will be the team to beat in 96. Leading the charge, Jerry Azuma. Azuma zoomed to 278 rushing yards at Lehigh and 265 yards at Villanova, the two highest totals in the storied 103-year history of UNH football. He became the first freshman in school history to rush for over 1,000 yards in a single season. He electrified fans and Division I AA football with skill, speed, and style, helping the 1995 Wildcats put an addition on a house full of football tradition. Freshman wasn't alone. From the high school hotbed of Pennsylvania came Dan Kreider. He made an impact at fullback in 1995. The tandem of Azuma and Kreider could be the best in the Yankee Conference for the next 3 years. And it just won't be a ground attack for the Wildcats. With his first year of collegiate experience under his belt, it should be fun watching the progression of quarterback Chris Bresnahan. He'll be back for his senior year, along with the top three receivers in 95.
Bresnahan wants to throw, looking down over the middle for Al Barrow. It's complete. Barrow's got open field the rest of the way to the 20, to the 15, to the 10. No flags. Alex Barrow, touchdown, Wildcats. 74 yards on the touchdown. Gets credit on defense. Bresnahan threw a perfect ball. Barrow made the catch and got it going afterwards.
Al Barrow pulled in 3 touchdowns in 1 game against Boston University. He was a big play man, while teammate Calvin Jones led the team in receptions. The two returned to make one of the top receiving tandems in New England football. Tight end Jeff Tomolsky returns after a year where he earned all New England honors and second team all conference honors. Next to the big tight end, some big men return on the front line. 4 players who played 3 games or more return. Mike White, freshman Greg Krause, and Pat Downey will vie for all conference honors. And there is plenty of depth all around, especially in the backfield, where Dave Lopez and JoJo Goodine proved they have what it takes in 95. The offense should be overpowering, but history tells us there's no overpowering the vaunted UNH defense. Plenty of talent returns on that side of the ball. led by the return of all three starting linebackers. They were three of the top five tacklers in 95. Peter Christopher led the Wildcats with 80 stops. Brendan Richter made more than his share of big plays on the other side. Inside, Romandy Carter can be one of the better linebackers the University of New Hampshire has ever produced. He proved that in 95. But the guys in front of the linebacking core may try to keep all the tackles for themselves. Freshman Matt Crispino had an incredible year, leading a great line in tackles. Bad news for the rest of the Yankee Conference. He got better as the season went along. Scary. James Rushton will be given an opportunity to do this on a regular basis as well. Maybe the two best athletes on the team are back in the defensive secondary. Joffrey Boyd had a flair for the flashy play, as did Reggie Keenan, who never backed down from making a big hit and provided his share of thrills and chills, contributing to the number one defense in the Yankee Conference. So much talent returns, and just think, there are other talented players waiting in the wings. Add it all together, and there's no question. Once again, the University of New Hampshire Wildcats will be one of the top football teams in the Yankee Conference, but I guess some things never change.